In this video, we'll introduce you to taplink's newest feature, the amazing custom block. We'll take a close look at the interface and go over each block's settings. By the end, we'll create a modern design from scratch. After watching, you'll have all your questions answered. So let's get started. Custom Block is a professional editor with a simple, user-friendly interface that can replace tools like Photoshop, Figma, Canva, and other graphic design software. Now, there is no need to create designs in third-party editors and then import them into taplink. Everything can be done directly within our platform. Our new tool lets you bring any design idea to life, from banners to product cards, and make your page truly one of a kind. You can easily update information like text, prices, and dates directly in taplink. Plus, all text in the custom block is indexed by search engines, unlike text on banners created in third-party graphic editors. You can also turn small elements like icons and buttons into links to any page. We've also created a variety of templates to save you time. They are easy to customize to fit your needs. Edit the text, upload your images, adjust the colors, remove elements or add new ones with just a few clicks. Custom block is available with the basic plan, while uploading your own images within the block is included in the pro and business plans. It's super easy to use, requires no special skills, and works seamlessly on both computers and phones. Now, let's dive deeper into this feature by exploring one of the ready-made templates as an example. In the center, we can see the custom block, a modular grid where you can add elements like text, buttons, rectangles, icons, shapes, and images. On the left, you'll see the layers panel, which displays all the elements you've added to your layout. Each layer can be hidden, locked, or reordered. To change the order of layers, hover over the six dots on the desired layer, hold down the left mouse button, and drag it up or down. Alternatively, select the layer and use the buttons below. Send backward, bring forward, or send to back, bring to front. On the right, you'll find the layout panel, which contains the layout settings. Here, you can customize the background by choosing a color from the palette, setting a custom color, or creating a gradient. Next, you can set a click action, which makes the entire block clickable. When clicked, it can perform actions like opening a website, navigating to an internal page, or accessing a digital product. Keep in mind that if you set a click action for the entire block, you won't be able to assign click actions to individual elements within it. Right now, we don't need the entire block to be clickable, so let's disable the click action by selecting the Do Nothing option. Additionally, you can adjust the size of the layout itself. By default, the layout is 8 columns by 6 rows, with a minimum size of 1 by 1 and a maximum size of 12 columns by 36 rows. The layout size can be changed at any time. Now, let's take a closer look at the elements that make up this template. It includes 3 text elements, 1 image, 1 shape, 1 rectangle, 1 button, and 3 icons. All elements in custom block can be customized. To open the settings for an element, simply click on it. Some settings are shared across multiple elements, while others are unique to specific ones. Let's start by looking at the settings that appear in several elements. Each element can be hidden or shown, locked or unlocked, duplicated and deleted. You can also add a background and round the corners for text, shapes, and images. The button, rectangle, and icon have an additional setting to add a border. Additionally, you can apply a shadow and blur to any element. You can also assign a click action to individual elements, making them clickable with any available action. And adjust internal padding on all sides, left, right, top, and bottom, with a maximum value of 40%. On a computer, you can also adjust padding directly on the element without opening the settings. To do this, hold down and drag the marker on the border where you want to add the padding. Now let's reset some settings to their default values. To do this, select the desired element, click on the setting title highlighted in gray, and then click Yes in the pop-up window. On a computer, you can also undo actions by pressing Ctrl plus Z and redo them by pressing Ctrl plus Shift plus Z. Now let's explore the unique settings for each element. For the text element, you can change the font size, font itself, and font color. You can choose from any Google font by simply typing the font name in the search bar. Additionally, you can adjust line spacing, letter spacing, and align the text to the left, center, right, or full widths. You can also make the text bold, italic, strike through, or underlined. And align the text vertically to the top, center, or bottom. For the image element, you can upload an image from the gallery or upload your own. All images can be cropped. By default, the cropping proportions match the element's dimensions, but you can adjust them if needed. You can either choose from preset aspect ratios or set a custom ratio. In this window, you also have the option to remove the background by clicking the Remove Background button. After adding the image, you can delete it, resize it, align it, choose a fill color, and adjust its transparency. For the shape element, you can customize the shape by dragging any of the square corners on the edges to adjust its form. You can also add more corners by clicking the plus sign. Additionally, you can upload an image as the background, similar to how we uploaded images earlier, and round all the corners of the shape. For the rectangle element, you can also upload an image as the background. The process is similar to what we've seen with the image and shape elements. For the button element, you can add your own button headline, change the font size, font itself, and font color. You can also adjust line spacing and letter spacing to customize it further. Finally, for the icon element, you can change the icon itself. The icon can only be selected from the library, so to find the right one, just enter a keyword in the search bar. You can also adjust the icon's color, size, and rotation. Now let's try creating our own custom block from scratch. I suggest we start with this banner as a base and recreate it step by step. Click on Custom Block and select the blank template option. First, let's increase the size of the layout. By default, it's 8 columns by 6 rows, but since the design we want to recreate is a bit longer, we'll need to add a few extra rows. Let's start by adding a white rectangle. We can simply select the space we need and then choose Rectangle from the options. Next, let's add a shape. Click on an empty cell and select Shape. Then drag the blue corners to adjust the shape to your liking. Once you have the shape, fill it with the desired color. Now let's add some text. Click Add and select Text. Move the text element to the desired location, stretch it to the right length and width, and then enter your text. Now reduce the text size a bit and set the alignment to left. Since the text is too close to the edge, let's add some left padding, about 15%. For this template, we are using the text element, but you could also replace it with an image of your logo if you prefer. Now let's add another text element. Click Add and select Text. Move it to the desired location, stretch it to the right length and width, and then add your text. Increase the size a bit, align it to the left edge, and add 15% internal left padding. By default, the text has quite a large line spacing, so let's reduce it to 1.20 for a better look. Now let's add another text element. Click Add and select Text. Move it to the desired location, stretch it to the right length and width, and then add your text. Increase the size, align it to the left edge, and add 15% internal left padding. Finally, make the text bold. These three text elements all have the same color. So, if you want to change the color of all of them at once, we can do it in a single action. Click on one of the elements, go to the color settings, select apply to all elements of this color, and then choose the desired color. As you can see, all of these elements will change to the new color at the same time. Now, let's add an image. Click add and select the image element. Choose the space where you want the image to appear, and then click upload. Select the picture you want, adjust the crop size as needed, remove the background, and click upload to add it. Next, let's add a button. By default, a small button is added, but we need to make it bigger. If we simply drag the blue dots, the button will become too long and large, but we can easily adjust the size by adding internal padding. Let's set 10% padding on the left, top, and right, and a slightly larger padding of 15% at the bottom, so the button isn't too tight against the edge. Now let's change the button headline and round the corners by setting the border radius to 100%. Finally, to make the button clickable, go to the Click Action tab, select Website, and enter the URL for the website. Now you can add an icon to the button if you'd like. Click Add and select the icon element. I want to place the icon on the right edge of the button, so I'll drag it there. The icon is too large right now, so let's resize it. To do this, drag one of the blue dots to make it smaller. Next, let's change the icon thumbnail. Click on the icon in the right panel, type arrow in the search bar, select the desired thumbnail, and click apply. Now change the icon color to white. Finally, I'll reduce the icon size a bit more in the size tab. Let's set it to 60%. Now, let's save our blog. Click Save Changes, and then click Save Changes again. If you skip the second step, the blog won't be saved. Now, let's see how this blog looks when we click on the link to our page. On the banner, our button is clickable, and when clicked, it redirects us to another site. This is how you can easily and quickly create unique blogs with your own design directly in Taplink. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments, and we'll make sure to answer them.